Okay, the next step is so in here I try to break them into two parts. The first part is to correlate the model eigengenes with other distract data, so for example with the sample information. So this is like, let's say I want to check like heat map to see that how the model correlate with all 180 samples here. So we can see from the heat map here. Okay, the next one is try to get it into like, maybe I don't really want to see what 180 samples, I want to see where are the zone that they're referring to. So I try to correlate with the sample tag, which is the zone. And here we need a bit of data manipulation to get the sample tag so that they can be plotted in the p-heat map. So we can see the zone here, zone 1, zone 2, zone 3. And this is the module in different color. Maybe we can try to see how much group they have divided based on the zone. So let's say here, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Maybe we can simply assign into 7 groups for this module. Okay, so this is how we deal with the discrete data. And the next one, part 2, is correlate between gene module and the continuous data. For example, here is the microbial trait. And so we can try to load the order of the bacteria. So the total of 234 bacteria orders, and it will be something like this. They are the profiling data for all these 234 bacteria order. This is their sample ID. So we will try to clean a bit the data so that we can use for the downstream. Okay, and we can check whether the role name of the ME, which is the module eigengenes, and this is the bacteria tag, they are all similar. So which means that we can do the correlation between them. So at here, they use the Pearson correlation, but based on your experiment need, you also can change it into other type of the correlation. Okay, so we try to correlate them and get the p-value. And next, we can try to plot the heat map between them. Okay, so the heat map is in the 5 module trait bacteria. Okay, yeah, so this is the, wow, it's the, because they have 234 bacteria order, so that's why it's very long here. And then this is all the module that having a correlation with them. So at this moment, this is have to give back to the scientists to make their own decision whether they want to focus into which module based on the heat map here. So for example, we see that maybe maybe we interested in this bacteria order, and this is the module that highly correlated with this bacteria order. So we can try to investigate further to this, yeah, to this module, and to see what are the genes and which within them or other network analysis. We can further narrow our analysis that target certain module with certain external trait. So here, maybe let's say I interested with this bacteria order, and I just try to focus on it. Okay, and then I can generate the so-called gene module membership between them, also the gene trait significance between them. So these two things will enable us to check their relationship. Let's say we can check the eigengene dendrogram, and we can see that, okay, for the bacteria order, it very closely related with the module eigengene light green here. Okay, so the next one is that we can plot in this way also to check the correlation. So this is the bacteria highly correlated with this color. This is the light green color. So that's why I further target light green color and get to see how the scatter plot of this. We can try to check the scatter plot here. Yeah. So this is that, how is the correlation of the module membership in this light green module versus the gene significance for this bacteria order. So we can see they are having correlation of 0.82, quite high here. Okay, and also we can use other way to visualize them. And here I will show here that is to use the bubble plot. You can see the bubble plot of all the bacterial order versus the single module. Okay, yeah, so it will be something like this. So this is the model, just one single model, and we can see that this bacterial order having high correlation with this. Yeah, I choose the light green models, yeah. Something like this. So that's all for the analysis about WGCNA, and the rest will be the downstream analysis about the gene set enrichment analysis or any other network analysis that you want to do. So a bit summary here, in order to do the WGCNA analysis, we need three types of data. The first is the expression data in whatever type of the expression data, as long as they are in the metric format. So we have to make the sample in rows and the genes in column. And also we need the sample metadata that correspond to the sample ID, and also the external trait that having similar sample ID and the expression data. And then once we have these three data set, we can try to proceed already. So the first step is to get the soft threshold power meter. This is to decide the power needed for the function to generate the network based on the dissimilarity calculation. Once we get the power, we can try to get the topological overlap metric here. And here we need to decide whether what is the term type, minimum module size, merge cut height. So all this you can just use the default way or can customize based on your data distribution. Okay, so there's actually having two options. You can just do it in one slot, that is the automatic way, or you can use it step by step so that you can modify or customize in step by step. Okay, so if let's say you choose the step by step way, you have to manually merge the module, and then you can try to export the network to external software. So this will be export for Shadowscape. I will show you in the next video. And then you can also try to correlate the module eigen genes with other data, other external trait, is for example other discrete data or other continuous data. There are two different ways to do this. And so while you have already having the targeted module, you can try to narrow down the analysis and to get more about what are the genes that bring high gene module membership and gene trait significant. Okay, so that's all for the tutorial today. I hope you have learned something from this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!